In this video, we are going to talk about enhancements to the production order release process. This illustration shows the production order release dialog box. A new field group called Release to Warehouse has been added. In the From Operation Number and To Operation Number fields, you can limit the release of materials to specific operations. In the Release Quantity field, you can limit the release of materials to a partial quantity of the production order. With these new capabilities, it's easier to control the amount of materials that you release and avoid building up unnecessary inventory on the shop floor. We are now going to show an example of how to use this functionality. A production order for 200 pieces of a cabinet assembly is prepared for this example. The production order has 3 bill of materials, also known as BOM lines. Each BOM line is set up to reserve at production order release. The production order has the status of scheduled. The scheduling can be seen on the Gantt chart. The production order has 2 operations, an assembly operation and a packing operation. The assembly operation consumes 2 materials, which can be seen in the job dialog box. The packing operation consumes 1 material. The assembly operation runs for a long time, so for now we will only release materials for the assembly operation. We won't release the material for the packing operation until it's about to start. We will select the release from the production order and open the release dialog box. In the release dialog box, we limit the release of materials to operation 10, which is the assembly operation. We also want to release the materials for the upcoming period, for example, the upcoming shift. So we will limit the release of materials for the assembly operation to only produce 50 cabinets out of the 200 cabinets that are planned for the production order. We can also select the unit in which the finished goods are produced. You can select units as defined in the unit sequence group that is specified for the finished good. In this example, 1 pallet equals 50 pieces of the finished good. We'll select each as a unit for release. We'll confirm the release. As we confirm the release, an info log appears showing that materials have been released to the warehouse. Looking at the work details for the production order, note that only the material for the assembly operation has been released, and only 1 pallet of each material has been released. In this case, 1 pallet is needed for 50 cabinets.